it was cast down, bowing themselves in the sujood, completely submitting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And not only that, they said, Qalu amanna bi rabbil alameen. They said, we submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is Rabb of alameen. And also they mention Rabb of Musa and Harun. Complete submission. So look at their iman. They were not scared of Pharaoh. They submitted because they recognized the truth. So here we see, قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ مِنْ شَرِّ مَا قَلَقَ وَمِنْ شَرِّ غَاسِقٍ إِذَا وَقَبَ وَمِنْ شَرِّ النَّفَّاثَاتِ فِي الْعُقَدِ وَمِنْ شَرِّ حَاسِدٍ إِذَا حَسَدَ. Here in this we say, I take refuge with the Lord of the daybreak from the evil of what He has created, from the evil of darknesses when it gathers, from the evil of the woman who blow knots. You know, when talking about here blowing knots, so who will be blowing knots? The people who are doing the black matching. When He envies, this is in Surah Al-Falaq 1-5. According to Qurtubi, woman in the above ayahs from the evil of the woman who blow the knots implies female sorcerers, sahirat, who blows on thread knots while creating their spells. Ibn Kathir stated that according to the scholar of exegesis, Mujahid, Ikrama, Al-Hasan, Qatada and Dahak, women in this verse is from the evil of the woman who blows on the knots, implies to female sorcerers. Okay. Ibn Jarir al-Tabari stated that according to Qasmiya and scholars to exegesis, women in the above ayahs from the evil of the woman who blows on the knots, implies female sorcerers who blow on the threaded knots during the spell. Overall, we see verses on black magic and sorcerers are profuse and known even to those with little knowledge of Islam. So evidence from Sunnah, black magic was performed on Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, so that he began to imagine that he was doing that which he was not. Aisha radiallahu anha reported, one day he invoked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for a long period and then said, I feel that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has inspired me as to how I should cure myself. Two persons came to me in my dream and sat. And you know, these dreams are truth. One by my head and the other by my feet. Who is saying? Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. One of them asked the other, what is the ailment of this man? About whom they are talking? About Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The other replied, he has been bewitched. Who? Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The first asked, who has bewitched him? The other replied, Lubayt ibn al-Asam. They know who did it. Okay. The first one asked, what material has he used? The other replied, a comb. The hair gathered on it. You know, when we comb and keep the comb there without removing the hair, sometimes even removing also, sometimes it remains one or two. So here we get the evidence that they took the hair. Okay. And the outer skin of the pollen of the male dat palm. The first asked, where is that? The other replied, it is in the well of Zarwan. There was a well called Zarwan. They planted over there. So Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam went out towards the well and then returned and said to me on his return, it's date palms. The date palms near the well are like the heads of the devil. How they look like? The heads of the devil. I asked, did you take out those things with which magic was performed? He said, no. For I have been cured by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and I am afraid that this action may spread even among the people. Later on, the well was filled up with the earth. You know, it was completely filled up with the earth. So what we learn here, that was not removed, but it was filled with the earth. So here in this hadith, refers to the black magic done to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the Jews hired Lubayt ibn al-Asam, one of the most skilled sorcerer among the Jews, to perform black magic on Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in return for 3 dinars, just for 3 dinars. Can you imagine? Astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah. to begin his work. It is believed that Lubaid obtained tufts of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam hair from a young female servant. Usually it happens this way, you know, the people who are accessible, they only helped. So here also the servant who used to go to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam house, he tied the hair to a knot using his spell on it and dropped in a well. According to different narration of the hadith, it appears that this black magic belonged to the category of causing sexually inability. As a result, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam imagined himself capable of having sexual intercourse with one of his wives, but when he approached her, he could not do it. Nevertheless, this type of black magic did not affect his brain. So remember that it did not affect his brain. Whenever wahi comes, he did the, like, you know, there was nothing wrong with his brain or nothing wrong with his memory, but was only confined to sexual performance. Okay. Scholars disagreed as to the duration of the spell. Some hold that it is lasted for 40 days. So there is a difference of opinion. So the other says some hold it lasted for 40 days, while others hold different opinions. The hadith also indicates that the Jews perform a black magic with the intent to kill Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Given that there are some lethal types of black magic, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved him, reduced to the least harmful type, a rabat, inability to have sexual intercourse with his wives. But refuting the views which reject the above tradition, according to Al-Maziri, Al-Mubtada'in, the innovators in the religions have rejected the above hadith on the grounds that it would undermine the status of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and cast doubts over his authenticity. So furthermore, accepting such a hadith would weaken the credibility of the Islamic law. So they also argued that when Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said the angel Jibril had come to him, he had only imagined him, that he had only imagined the divine inspiration. But according to Al-Maziri, this is incorrect, because the proof of message, which is miracle of receiving divine inspiration, is indicative of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam truthfulness and his infallible character in conveying the message. Therefore, believing in something that has been invalidated too. We were doing black magic in the light of Quran and Sunnah. Let's continue. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajeem. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Surah At-Taha, ayah number 67 and 69. So here we see Musa alayhi salam conceive here with the himself, you know, because fa'awjasa fi nafsihi khifata Musa. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, fear not, you know, la taqaf, innaka antal a'la, surely you will have the upper hand. Allah is saying that, and throw that which is in your right hand, and it will swallow up that which they have made. You know, all the magicians, they were doing the tricks. Then after that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked Musa al-Islam to, you know, throw the asa, the staff, and it will swallow everything. That which they have made it, only a magician's trick, and the magician will never be successful to whatever amount of skill he may attain. And here later we see Suratul Araf, ayah number 117 to 122, and we reveal to Musa al-Islam, throw your staff, and behold, it swallowed up straight away all the falsehood which they showed, so that truth came to pass and false was proved that which they were doing. So they were defeated there and returned in disgrace, and the sorcerer were cast down, bowing themselves. They said, we believe in Allah, Rabbul Alameen, jinn and mankind, the Lord of Musa and Harun. Subhanallah. Wa awhayna ila Musa an alqi asaka fa iza hiya talqaf ma ya'fikun fa waqa al-haqq wa balbat وَبَتَلَ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ فَغُلِبُ الْحُنَالِكَ بَنْقَلَبُ الْسَاغِرِينَ وَأَلْقِ السَّحْرَةُ السَّاجِدِينَ. They went into the sajda prostrating. And what else they did? قَالُوا آمَنَّ بِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ رَبِّ مُوسَى وَهَارُونَ. And now they said, we believe. Like, you know, all of a sudden, when they saw how he swallow up, you know, and that moment of time in the tafsir it comes, wa ulqiya sahratu sajidin. As soon as they, it was cast down, bowing themselves in the sujood, completely submitting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And not only that, they said, qalu amanna bi rabbil alameen. They said, we submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is Rabb of alameen. And also they mention Rabb of Musa and Harun. Complete submission. So look at their iman. They were not scared of Pharaoh. They submitted because they recognize the truth. So here we see, قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ مِنْ شَرِّ مَا قَلَقَ وَمِنْ شَرِّ غَاسِقٍ إِذَا وَقَبَ وَمِنْ شَرِّ النَّفَّاثَاتِ فِي الْعُقَدِ وَمِنْ شَرِّ حَاسِدٍ إِذَا حَسَدَ. Here in this we say, I take refuge with the Lord of the daybreak from the evil of what He has created, from the evil of darknesses when it gathers, from the evil of the woman who blow knots. You know, when talking about here blowing knots, so who will be blowing knots? The people who are doing the black matching. When he envies, this is in Surah Al-Falaq 1-5. According to Qurtubi, woman in the above ayahs, from the evil of the woman who blow the knots, implies female sorcerers. Sahirat, who blows on thread knots while creating their spells. Ibn Kathir stated that according to the scholar of Exegesis, Mujahid, Ikrima, Al-Hasan, Qatad and Dahak, women in this verse is from the evil of the woman who blows on the knots, implies to female sorcerers. Okay. Ibn Jarir Tabari stated that according to Qasmiya and scholars to Exegesis, women in the above ayahs from the evil of the woman who blows on the knots, implies female sorcerers who blow on the threaded knots during the spell. Overall, we see verses on black magic and sorcerers are profuse and known even to those with little knowledge of Islam. So, evidence from Sunnah. Black magic was performed on Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, so that he began to imagine that he was doing that which he was not. Aisha radiallahu anha reported, one day he invoked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for a long period and then said, I feel that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has inspired me as to how I should cure myself. Two persons came to me in my dream and sat, and you know these dreams are truth. One by my head and the other by my feet. Who is saying? Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. One of them asked the other, what is the ailment of this man? About whom they are talking? About Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The other replied, he has been bewitched. Who? Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The first asked, who has bewitched him? The other replied, Lubayt ibn al-Asam. They know who did it. Okay. The first one asked, what material has he used? The other replied, a comb. The hair gathered on it. You know, when we comb and keep the comb there without removing the hair, sometimes even removing also, sometimes it remains one or two. So here we get the evidence that they took the hair. Okay. And the outer skin of the pollen of the male dat palm. The first asked, where is that? The other replied, it is in the well of Zarwan. There was a well called Zarwan. They planted over there. So Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam went out towards the well and then returned and said to me on his return, its date palms, the date palms near the well are like the heads of the devil. How they look like? The heads of the devil. I asked, did you take out those things with which magic was performed? He said, no, for I have been cured by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and I am afraid that this action may spread evil among the people. Later on, the well was filled up with the earth. You know, it was completely filled up with the earth. So what we learn here, that was not removed, but it was filled with the earth. So here in this hadith refers to the black magic done to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the Jews hired Lubayd ibn al-Asam, one of the most skilled sorcerer, among the Jews to perform black magic on Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam in return for 3 dinars, just for 3 dinars. Can you imagine? Astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah. To begin his work, it is believed that Lubayd obtained tufts of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam hair from a young female servant. Usually it happens this way, you know, the people who are accessible, they only helped. So here also the servant who used to go to Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam's house, he tied the hair to a knot using his spell on it and dropped in a well. According to different narration of the hadith, it appears that this black magic belonged to the category of causing sexually inability. As a result, Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam imagined himself capable of having sexual intercourse with one of his wives, but when he approached her, he could not do it. Nevertheless, this type of black magic did not affect his brain. So remember that it did not affect his brain. Whenever wahi comes, he did the, like, you know, there was nothing wrong with his brain or nothing wrong with his memory, but was only confined to sexual performance. Okay. Scholars disagreed as to the duration of the spell. Some hold that it is lasted for 40 days. So there is a difference of opinion. So the other says, some hold it lasted for 40 days, while others hold different opinions. The hadith also indicates that the Jews perform a black magic with the intent to kill Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Given that there are some lethal types of black magic, but Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala saved him, reduced to the least harmful type, a rabat, inability to have sexual intercourse with his wives. But refuting the views which reject the above tradition, according to Al-Mazari, Al-Mubtada'in, the innovators in the religions have rejected the above hadith on the grounds that it would undermine the status of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and cast doubts over his authenticity. So furthermore, accepting such a hadith would weaken the credibility of the Islamic law. So they also argued that when Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said the angel Jibreel had come to him, he had only imagined him, that he had only imagined the divine inspiration. But according to Al-Mazari, this is incorrect, because the proof of message, which is miracle of receiving divine inspiration, is indicative of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam truthfulness and his infallible character in conveying the message. Therefore, believing in something that has been invalidated by evidence is wrong. So, according to Abu Al-Janki and Yusufi, the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam illness results from effect of black magic done to him did not affect the status of prophethood. So, we have to understand, he was truthful and it does not affect his prophethood. And this, because of this ailment, without any adverse effect in his life, befell messengers at a large and would even increase their status in the next life. Therefore, the fact that Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam imagined, okay, as a result of illness caused by black magic, that he had done something of life's routine, you know, daily routine, chores, he imagined that, but he didn't do it. So previously, many scholars, they reject that hadith. Okay, I hope that is clear. Don't ask those questions, oh, how come you quoted the da'if hadith? I'm just reading the difference of opinions, what they say regarding that matter. So I hope this is clear. Routine activities which he had not really done, and the fact that he completely recovered from such an ailment through the support of Allah. What happened? Gradually he improved with the Allah Subhanahu Ta'ala's will, who revealed the site with the spell was buried, meaning that Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam would not affect by this at all. This was like an other ailment. Like how you fell sick and then you are cured, the same way he got cured, and that well was filled with the earth. The black magic did not affect his reasoning, but only his perception. So Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam imagined doing things such as touching one of his wives, which he had not really done, and in terms of ailment. So the previously what I mentioned, that was the opinion, and they said they reject those regarding the, you know, doing sexual intercourse and not doing it. and not having the ability, that is not the thing. Okay, the reality here, some of the scholars says, just touching one of his wives, which he had not really done. Okay, and in terms of ailments, such acts of imagination are not harmful. It was only personal things, nothing related to wahi or anything. And there are some who believe that the Prophet ﷺ ailment as a result of black magic degraded his message. No, nothing like that. Don't believe in such thing. And the explicit story of Musa al-Islam with the Pharaoh and all those things has been mentioned. And Musa al-Islam, to be firm and not to fear anything. And in that we see in Surah Taha, ayah number 67 to 69, and here I'm going to just read this and then stop here. We'll continue in the third part. So here Musa al-Islam conceived fear with himself. With Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, fear not, surely you'll have the upper hand. And we have seen this ayah before, and throw that which is in your right hand. It will swallow up that which have made. That which they have made it only a magic trick, and the magician will never be successful. So here Musa al-Islam has been convinced by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you do not fear, you throw what is in your hand, that is staff, and the staff and magicians, wala yuflihu sahiru haiswata, wherever the magicians comes from, they are not successful. And we'll continue in the next clip. Jazakallah khairan kaseer. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Welcome to Ramadan series, last 10 nights. Nahmaduhu nusalli ala rasulihi kareem, amma baad. Fawz billahi minash shaitanir rajeem. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Rabbi shrah li sadri wa yassir li amri wa hlul uqdatam min lisani yafqahu qawli. Rabbi zidni ilma. The night of our destiny, Laylatul Qadr. What is the meaning and significance of Laylatul Qadr? There's a surah in Quran, Suratul Qadr. Inna anzalnahu fi Laylatul Qadr. Indeed, we sent the Quran down during the night of decree. Wama adraka ma Laylatul Qadr. And what can make you know what is the night of decree? Laylatul Qadri khayrun min alf shahr. The night of decree is better than a thousand months. Tanazzalu al malaikatu bi ruhi fiha bi izni rabbihim min kulli amr. The angels and the spirit descend there by permission of their Lord for every matter. Salamun hiya hatta matla' al fajr. Peace it is until the emergence of dawn. Suratul Qadr. Inna anzalna fi laylatul qadr. Indeed, we sent down the Quran during the night of decree. And there is a surah, Surah Dukhan, surah number 44. Here it talks about Hameen by the clear book. Hameen wal kitabil mubin. Inna anzalnahu fi laylatul mubarakatan. Inna kunna munzirin. Indeed, we sent it down during a blessed night. Which blessed night? Laylatul Qadr. Indeed, we were to warn mankind. On that night is made distinct every precise matter. Fiha yufraku kullu amri hakim. Every matter proceeding from us. Indeed, we were to send a messenger. A mercy from your Lord. Indeed, He is ever knowing. Powerful meaning of Qadr, significance, predestination, restriction, multiplication, Mubarak. Understand the hadith. There are other ways of understanding the authentic hadith of Prophet ﷺ regarding Laylatul Qadr. For example, Prophet ﷺ said, seek it in the last 10 days of Ramadan, when there are 9 days left, 7 days left, 5 days left. This is in Bukhari. Ibn Taymiyyah explained his hadith. Odd numbers have to do with what is past. when one starts counting from beginning of the month. So it should be sought on the 21st, 23rd, 25th, 27th and 29th. Or it may be with the regard to what is left of the month. As Prophet ﷺ said, when there are 9 left or 7 left or 5 left or 3 left, on this basis, if the month has 30 days, this will be even numbered nights. So on the 22nd, there will be 9 days left. On 24th, there will be 7 days. This is how it was explained by Abu Sa'id al-Khudri in Sahih Hadith. And this is how Prophet ﷺ prayed Qiyam during this month. In this case, the believer should seek it in all last 10 days. In other words, the odd nights of the last 10 nights of Ramadan might actually be the even nights, even if we look it backward. This shows that it is possible that Laylatul Qadr might be on even nights. There is a difference in sighting of the moon. You understand? There may be. And also, put into consideration, according to the majority of Sahaba and Ulama, it is almost likely on the 27th of Ramadan. But of course, we don't know that for sure. So try our best to seek it in all of the last 10 nights. Jazakallah khairan.
رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. ان شاء الله we will do سورة القرآن juice number 27. ان شاء الله we will start from سورة الزاريات until سورة الحديث. So we are doing a couple of surahs here, and as I mentioned before, we are doing short summary. Let's start. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قال فما قطبكم أيها مرسلون. Ibrahim al-Islam said, then what is your business here, O messengers? So previously in the surah we have seen, you know, he came with the good news to the Ibrahim al-Islam, and then after that, even though he heard the good news, Ibrahim al-Islam, but he asked the messenger, what is the second thing, you know, why you came here, what is the reason behind it? قَالُوا إِنَّا أُرْسِلْنَا إِلَىٰ قَوْمٍ مُجْرِمِينَ. They said, indeed we have been sent to a people of criminals. So لِنُرْسِلَ عَلَيْهِمْ حِجَارَةٌ مِنْ طِينٍ, and to send down upon them stones of clay marked in the presence of your Lord for the transgressors. So we brought but who in the cities of the believers. And here, you know, this talking about people of Lut al-Islam, because they were transgressing and they were doing the homosexual and so on. So they will have the painful punishment. And later on, Musa al-Islam was mentioned, how Musa al-Islam was sent to Pharaoh and the clear authority and clear signs and how all the things happened. And finally, he has the success and he rescued the Bani Israel. And when we destroyed the people of Nuh, before indeed they were people defiantly disobedient. And here talking about the people of Nuh al-Islam, how they were, you know, even though he was conveying the message, but they were not listening to it. And the heaven he constructed, the strength, and indeed they are just its expander. And here later on we see, and it is do not make equal with Allah, and they were doing shirk. And when many other nations, whenever they were reminded of believing in Allah, they were doing shirk. In ayah number 56, وَمَا قَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَإِنْسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ, and I did not create jinn and mankind except to worship me. This is very important ayah. And regarding this ayah number 56, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, there is a hadith, he who died knowing fully well that there is no God but Allah, he will enter paradise, saying La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. And here later on we see, Inna Allah wa Razzaq, indeed it is Allah.